The consciousness. mind is free from the influence of the past, the mind is free from the influence of the future, and the mind is free from reactions in the present. The past influences the present. The past experiences. When there is no closure, as they say, when an experience leaves a residue, if, in my opinion, I have been treated unfairly, if I feel injustice has been done to me, then that experience may leave a sense of hurt. I feel I have been insulted. I feel I have been treated in an unfair manner, in an unjust manner. That is, of course, my perception. But that is how I interpret an experience. Then lives in my mind a feeling of hurt. Over all the years through countless experiences with people, and it is likely that many of those experiences have left the impression and the feeling of hurt. Sometimes from father, sometimes from mother, sometimes from other elders, from relatives, friends, from childhood. I've gone through many experiences. It's likely that those experiences have left in me a sense of hurt, and therefore a sense of resentment for those who caused me hurt. That makes me sad. There should be closure to those experiences by the attitude of forgiveness, by the attitude of large-heartedness, I forgive those who have hurt me. I recognized that at that time when I was hurt, the behavior of the individuals was hurtful. But now, in my wisdom and maturity of the present, I recognize that those who hurt me by insulting me by being unfair to me, those people themselves were in pain. It is their pain which caused them to behave in a hurtful way. A happy person cannot hurt another one. Only an unhappy person can hurt out of unhappiness. Therefore, they deserve to be forgiven. My sense of hurt and resentment is when I react to the behavior. But when I take into account the person behind the behavior, a hurt person, a person in pain, whether it is my father, my mother, my relative, my friend, my boss, any other individual who have mistreated me, caused hurt in me, in the hindsight, I realized that each one of them was in pain when they behaved in that particular manner. That is how sympathy, compassion gets invoked in me. It is the sympathy or compassion for the pain of the person that removes the sense of resentment or hurt. I forgive all those who caused me hurt in the past, because they were hurt themselves, because they themselves were in pain. They deserve my sympathy, my compassion. That is the way to make the mind free from the hurts of the past. It is quite likely that just as others hurt me, I also may have hurt others on some other occasions, because of which I'm carrying a sense of guilt. Hurt because of others' behavior, guilt because of my improper behavior. I seek pardon from those whom I hurt. I admit that I also acted out of anger or resentment. The hurts and guilts of the past. They have to be resolved. Because they cause sadness in the present. I forgive all those who have hurt me and I seek forgiveness from those whom I have hurt. The future also influences the present, because the future is uncertain. I have no control over the future. Therefore, there is anxiety. If the future turns out to be unpleasant, anxiety about the possible unpleasantness of the future, that causes anxiety and there was sadness in the present. Anxiety also makes me sad. I can become free from anxiety when I'm prepared to gracefully accept whatever the future brings. Knowing that whatever will come, will be given by Ishvara. Whatever happened in the past was also caused by Ishvara through those people. People are only instruments. Like puppets, it is Ishvara who is functioning through them. The future also will be determined by Ishvara. And in my trust, Ishvara is my well-wisher. The Shraddha or the trust that Ishvara is a well-wisher, I am ready to agree to the future without fear or anxiety. That is the prasada buddhi. Forgiveness or accommodation about the past. Prasada buddhi, graceful acceptance of the future. And love in the present. Whoever is in my life in the present, who caused this reaction in me, the attachments and aversions in the present, lovingly accepting everyone in my life in the present, makes my mind free from reactions. People are what they are because Ishvara has made them to be so. I give freedom to others to be what they are. Then no reaction towards them. No aversion in the present. Making my mind free from the residue of the past by forgiveness. Making my mind free from the anxieties of future by prasada buddhi. Making my mind free from the reactions in the present by giving others the freedom to be what they are, by gracefully accepting them as they are. Making my mind free from the influence of the past, future and present. That is how I discover the freedom. Even though freedom is my nature, happiness is the nature of the mind. I do not need to do anything to be happy, because happiness is the nature of the mind. Accept that happiness is denied by the past, future, and present reactions. I don't want to acquire happiness. I do get rid of unhappiness by removing the causes of unhappiness, the right attitudes, right attitude towards the past, right attitude towards the future, right attitude towards the present. Attitude makes my mind free from the burden which I am carrying on my own. Others just become instrumental. Sparshan krutva bahir bahyan, keeping the external things out there. When I do not bring them in through these wrong attitudes, a right attitude I keep the outside world outside. And in turn, I enjoy the freedom. Freedom means happiness. Happiness, peace, freedom is my nature. Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. Shivoham, Shivoham. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo